Hello my dear students, and welcome to the one more video of the topic matrices. It's a third video of topic matrices. In the previous two videos we have already discussed with the types of matrices and the algebra of matrices. Now today we will discuss about what is mean by singular and non-singular matrices along with the transpose of matrix. So let's see. Let's first see singular and non-singular matrices. So what is mean by singular matrix? Any square matrix A is said to be singular if and only if the value of determinant of matrix A is 0. To check whether the matrix is singular or non-singular, it should be first of all a square matrix. For square matrices only we can check the singularity and non-singularity, because we have to find out its determinant value. And for determinant, the number of rows and columns should be same, that is known to us. Hence, for square matrices, where the number of rows and columns are same, we can calculate determinant value, and hence we will calculate the singularity. Okay, so for singular matrices, the determinant value of that particular matrix A, it should be 0. So this way you can find out, write those elements into determinant form, expand it or evaluate it, check whether it is 0 or not. If the value is 0, the matrix is called singular matrix. And the second possibility is non-singular matrices. So obviously, for non-singular matrices, your determinant value should be non-zero. So if determinant A is non-zero, we can say the matrix is non-singular. Let's see one example. It's a 3 by 3 matrix now, with the respective elements 4, minus 2, 3, 6, 7, 1, 4, 0, 2. So to check whether it is singular or not, we have to write the matrix into determinant form first. So you have to write this step compulsory, that determinant of A. Or this way also you can write into two vertical bars and put the elements into two vertical bars, right, that is into the determinant form first and then expand it. You are not supposed to expand that matrix itself. Okay, so let's expand it. 4 into, this is 14 minus 0. Next, minus of minus 2. Minus is the sign of expansion here. So minus of minus 2, it will be plus further. Then 12 minus 4. And last, plus 3 into 0 minus 28. The expansion of determinant is already known to you. We have studied it in the last chapter. So hope this is clear to all of you. And hence further it is calculated as 56. This is plus 2 into 8, that is plus 16 minus 84. And hence it is minus 12. See, the value is non-zero. So what we can conclude? We can conclude that the matrix is non-singular. Okay. Now let's see. Next one. That is transpose of matrix. So for transpose of any matrix, it can be obtained by just interchanging rows into columns. It's again a very simple concept. You just have to interchange rows and columns. So how to write that transpose? First of all, let us see. Transpose of a matrix A, it is denoted by either this way, A dash, or A raised to small c, or A raised to capital T. But for all these types, you have to read it as A transpose or A transpose or A transpose. The pronunciation should be same. Let's see one example. This is an example of now column matrix. It's a column matrix, right? Because there are three rows and one column. Three rows, one column. So it's a column matrix. So how to write its transpose? It is simply equal to what we have to do. We have to just interchange row into column. So now your first row becomes first column. This is your second row, it becomes second column, and third row becomes third column. So that column matrix will get now replaced, or it is interchanged into a row matrix. See, your order will again get interchanged. 3 by 1, it will be now, it is now 1 by 3 matrix. Next, see one more example of rectangular matrix. It's a matrix of order 3 by 2, 3 rows, 2 columns. So when you want to write it's a transpose, you again have to interchange rows into columns. See, first row becomes first column. This is your second row, it becomes second column. And third row, you have to write into third column. Okay, so now the order again get interchanged. 3 by 2 becomes 2 by 3. Two rows and three columns are there. So this way, these two concepts are very simple. Singularity, you have to check only for square matrices. And transpose, we can do it for any type of rectangular matrices. Both the concepts are very simple. Hope it is clear to all of you. Fine. So in the next video, we'll solve some examples related to that, related to these two topics. For this video today, we'll stop. Thank you.